Hello everyone, welcome to the IchimokuCharts.com hourly analysis for the S&P 500 for Thursday, March 10th, 2011. Well, a very bearish start to the trading day today. The first hour of trading, the market began this, or continued this downtrend that we were in with a very, very bearish candle, a very large red body candle. The market gapped down at the open and actually created the window that we see. The window, the borders of it are actually highlighted by these two lines that are within the cloud. So if the market does rally up to that area eventually, that window will offer itself as potential resistance. So we do need to be aware of that. Now back to this initial hour of trading, a very, very bearish hour. And when we get extremely bearish time periods like that, it's not unusual to see the market relax, and that's exactly what happened in this second hour of trading. We actually saw the bears lose the power that they had, and we saw a small green body candle with a large shadow on the bottom. Now that coincided with the market trading within this large highlighted area that we've spoken about before. And this is an area that we expected would hold as an important area of support for this market. We can see that the market's traded in around 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and now 6 occasions, and the area has held a support. We actually tested to the bottom of that area again. And you can see here previously, a few weeks ago, that the market traded to exactly the bottom of that area, and that was a previous area of support and resistance that we highlighted with this move line, which defined the bottom of this large zone. The large shadow on the bottom of this candle highlighted the sellers losing commitment and the buyers trying to take control of this market in that hour of trading. The market continued to rally, but that rally ran out of steam. So clearly the sellers were in the ascendancy, and in the third last hour of trading, they once again exerted the pressure that they had shown in the first hour of trading by another larger red body candle, certainly not as large as the opening hour of trading, but large enough to take out the previous three candles, or the bodies of the previous three candles, where the bulls were actually showing some net progress to the upside. We also had the shadow on the bottom of this candle, though, and that was at that area again at 129.5, roughly. And the sellers lost their commitment once again. The buyers in the second hour of trading tried to take control again, but neither side closed with control in that second last hour, with the market closing in the middle of the range, although the buyers did make net bullish progress. But in the final hour of trading, the bears once again showed their ascendancy with a very large red body candle. So we've had, in all of this trading for today, we've had three very large red body candles and a series of very small green body candles as the market tried to rally. So I think that says something about the overall lying strength of this market, that the bears really are in the ascendancy here. Now we also, in Ichimoku charts terms, had the breakout to the downside below the cloud, and that's a bearish signal. The only trouble is, as we've spoken before, if we have very strong support down below, then we have to be very careful of these signals, and the market could hold up at that support. This market also broke out from a flat part of the cloud, and quite often that can be a false signal. In this case, it wasn't, because there was so much bearishness in this market, but the market certainly didn't go on with the move past this support. Now, by the market trading down below the cloud, the market has an overall negative bias in big picture terms, but we've seen recently that the market's been oscillating above and below this the cloud. So we do need to be careful here and look for some sign that the market is not going to start retracing back towards the cloud. Now, the best sign of that will be a bearish breakout down below this zone of support. If we have that bearish breakout, then I'd have to say that this oscillation above and below the Ichimoku indicators has finished, and the market will be perhaps headed lower. In relation to the other indicators, we are trading down below the Kijunsen, which is the pink line, so that tells us that the market is negative in the medium-term time frame. We can see that the market in the opening hour of trading actually set us up with a second time frame downtrend, where we had the market making a peak, a trough, a lower peak, and a lower trough as we took out the peak from yesterday. The trough from yesterday with today's first hour of trading. In the third last hour of trading, we actually also made another lower peak and a lower trough. So the downtrend is quite strong, has a fair bit of momentum, and that momentum is shown by the fairly steep angle of the Kijunsen, the pink line here. The the Tenkan-sen is the lightish blue line, and that represents a trend in the medium term, in the fast term time frame. And the market action is trading down below there, so we're bearish in that time frame as well. The angle on that line is not as pointing down as steep as the Kijunsen, and that's reflecting this small amount of congestion that we're getting. The bulls trying to take over, but the bears coming back in, and the market testing the area at 129.5 with these three lows of these three candles. Now, just one thing to watch out for in candlestick terms, this is a potential tweezers bottom pattern, and that's where we have roughly the two candles here at roughly the same area. You can have a candle or two in between, and there is potential for a change of trend to the upside. So we do need to watch the high of the final candle, which is at 1299. So that coincides with the 1300 area. That's quite important for this market too. The 1300 area was taken out by the initial hour of trading, and the market tested up above there, so we're oscillating around that zone. We haven't closed down there in a substantial way yet for on the hourly charts for this to be definite break of that 1300 zone. But obviously now the 1300 area may offer itself as resistance for the market. If the market does rally, however, we do have this zone that we're trading in that could offer itself as resistance all the way up to 1309. Certainly anywhere where the Kijunsen and Tenkan-sen are trading, roughly in that area as well, up around 1310. And we have resistance offered around 1312, and then certainly through the cloud and up into the cloud around the window that's within the cloud as well. Now, if the market does become quite bullish and rally, then we will be interacting with a very small part of the cloud, which will offer a lesser amount of resistance than we've seen previously in the today's trading and the previous day's trading. So if the market is bullish enough, then there is potential to break the top side of the cloud and test up around the 1325 level. But let's not preempt the market. This is looking, in terms of the dynamics here, what the candles are telling us and the bearishness in these candles when they've been negative. It is looking like the market is setting up to take out the support offered around 1295 and test to lower levels.